Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. Our question this week is one that I've gotten from many people recently regarding trees that have fallen over. Having experienced this in my own yard, I know how nightmarish it can be. Almost a year ago, after the abundant and unusual amount of late summer and early fall rain we received, and during a particularly heavy storm, my 5-year-old moderate oak toppled over. Luckily, this wasn't the result of the trunk breaking, but rather the entire root ball heaved up out of the ground. I wasn't able to deal with the issue for a few days, and so I didn't hold out much hope for the tree's survival. Of course, I could have gone ahead and removed the tree, but I decided to stake it and see what would happen, having lost nothing but time and the cost of a few T-posts if it didn't work. So with a little help, I righted the tree back to vertical and tied it with strong rope to 3 stakes, which I left in place for about 9 months. Today, you'd never be able to tell that anything ever happened. The tree didn't lose a single branch and seems perfectly fine. But I know that below the soil it isn't fine, and the roots have a long way to go before I can reliably believe that the tree is stable, so I'm still hoping for the best. In another instance of tree toppling, we recently lost a mature Texas mountain laurel in our demonstration garden. In this instance, the problem was more severe. Back in June, one entire side of the multi-trunk tree snapped off at the baseline, leaving no opportunity for repair. I knew that if we had any hope of saving the remaining half of the tree that we'd need to stake it, but I got busy and lost track of time. And sure enough, only 2 months later, the other half of the tree broke at the base and toppled over. So what's going on with these falling trees? Years of drought have kept them from growing a healthy, widely dispersed root system. So even though they're most likely branching and putting on top growth, they aren't able to develop and sustain much root mass to support that growth. Then, more recently, we've had an overabundance of rainfall, leading to wet, unstable soil. In the case of my Monterey oak, it was young and not as heavy. But with our Texas mountain laurel, it was quite mature, and the recent rainfall allowed and encouraged it to produce a heavy crop of seeds. Also, it had other plants around it, and the trunk was staying far too wet, leading to rot. Our plant this week is possumhaw holly, Ilex decidua, a deciduous, medium-sized shrub that can be trained into a small, multi-trunk tree. Covered with striking red berries all winter, possumhaw holly brings beauty to what might otherwise be a colorless winter landscape. Those berries are also great winter food source for birds. Also known as winterberry for obvious reasons, possumhaw holly does well with very little care or maintenance, although you might want to prune it a bit to shape it. Plant in full sun or light shade and water sparingly once established. Getting only 15 to 20 feet tall and branching to almost as wide at maturity, possumhaw holly tends to have a twiggy growth habit that some may not find attractive. But if you have an area that you tend to leave a bit on the natural, even wild side, this shrub will look right at home. Our viewer picks this week come from Brenda Miles of a monarch caterpillar on tropical milkweed and from Brett Sanders of a katydid chilling on his plumeria. We'd love to hear from you, so please visit us at klru.org/ctg to send us your questions and photos.